have heard from Mr. Myers and Mr. Zoli, both will be late. Next item.
1.04, approval of agenda.
We have a request to remove 3.03 from the agenda. And our attorney will be coming around 7 o'clock, so wherever we are at in the agenda, if we can entertain the thought of going back there, so we're not paying for our attorney fees, we're going to sit there and do nothing.
Make a motion.
Support.
Motion and support as amended. All of the, any comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes 5-0. Next item.
1.05, approval of minutes.
Motion.
Support.
Motion by Mrs. Lucato, supported by Mr. Hackett, to approve the minutes for the public budget hearing of 6:25. Regular board meeting minutes on 6:25 and a special board meeting on 6:26. Any questions or comments about the minutes? All of the favors say aye.
Aye.
That passes 5-0. Next item.
1.01, superintendent and assistant superintendent reports.
We have a lot of handouts tonight, so I think everybody has them, at least for me, already in front of you. So I have my update and a couple of paperclip handouts along with it. Jumping right in, this is kind of a second round of summer project updates. I was over at SGA today. The asbestos tile abatement is complete in the office and in the media center, so that has been handled. Met with the tile company today. They're starting to work on the tiling process over there. Movers have moved all the inactive special education files over from Taylor High School. Painting of SGA is underway. Painting at Taylor High is progressing nicely, and work on the science lab includes currently the removal of the old sink pedestals, with the next step grinding down the concrete so they can retile those sections of the floor. Ceiling tiles are being removed from Kennedy and stored for transport over to Taylor High. Quotes are being solicited from various vendors for options for the flexible learning space, otherwise known as the Google Hangout, which will be in the center of the commons at Taylor High School. Window crews are scheduling their work at a few elementary schools. The window installers are meeting tomorrow at Randall, and I believe the following week at Eureka Heights. The wall, thanks to our heavy equipment at dividing the Zatney Lab, has been built. The electrical conduit has been run. The two sides of the wall have been drywalled, and mudding and sanding and painting still remains, but almost finished there. The former large special education ancillary staff rooms have been emptied, so the moving company has managed to clear those out and have those materials over at SGA. And the next step there, of course, will be for heavy equipment to cut a doorway, divide the rooms into three by building two walls to create the three classrooms. The concession stand's been painted. The final ticket sale window opening's been cut. The roll-up doors PO approved, and the roll-ups ordered. Electrical wiring was run today. The next step, and almost the final step really, will be the drop ceiling, the lights in the ceiling, and installing the countertops and the roll-ups. The exterior lights at the facility will be on a timer. The extra set of red lockers that were able to be moved, removed out of the women's locker room over to West to serve as West Middle School football equipment lockers. That's good news. They're already red. So that works out to everyone's advantage. We've talked about some roof leaks, and this one's a little different than a roof leak, but we had another spate of heavy rains. Toward the end of last week, heavy rain created a leak in the interior hallway pipe that is a roof drain that comes down from the flat roof there at Taylor High. An interior 4-inch pipe cap popped off, which then began, with all the rain draining, flood the hallways. Thanks to quick work by Kathy Fields and Mary Ann, work crews were dispatched to stop the leak and suck up the water. Plumbers found the source of the backup, I believe, today or over the weekend, which turned out they ran a camera down there about 100 feet and found a pop bottle stuck in the 4-inch drain. So apparently it was dropped through from the roof, made it a fair amount of the way down, and then over time silt and sediment built up to block the drain. So our plumbers are working on using an extraction tool and get company work began officially on July 3rd. Last week, they were able to move 76 of the inactive file cabinets from special ed over to SGA, and all the furniture for the ancillary staff out of the rooms was moved as well. Next step will be they're targeting this Thursday and Friday to tackle the inactive files from people accounting and then start the next phase of the move, which is then all the general move of the materials from inside of Taylor High, from some rooms over to other rooms, and then the materials coming over from Kennedy. The days that the work crews have worked, they've been working a six-man crew using a full-size 18-wheeler, and they've got all the rolling dollies and all the equipment and have been doing a nice job. So they're coordinating with our staff pretty well. At the special board meeting last Monday, TFT President Linda Moore raised a few questions about placement of teachers in the district, how she had felt that some current teachers had been disadvantaged with the current process. So I wanted to provide just an update on the process that the district's used, certainly with respect to language going back some years. So with this update, you'll have some attachments. You'll see four job postings dating as far back to July of 2009, where you'll see the language for and the requirements for internal and external candidates being essentially the same since 2009. In addition to that, the process we used, I think really speaks to specifically with those differentiating between how we screen and scrutinize internal applicants versus external applicants. And so this year, as we did last year with the wish list process, building level principals were wish list or creating a wish list opportunity. And that wish list opportunity including request to either stay at the same grade, move to a different grade, or even request to move to another building. And so those movements were happening and taking place prior to the June 15th deadline, which is a contractual deadline that HR must issue the tentative assignment letters. So that process was followed. In addition, one thing we did not do was ask any internal applicants to follow the current process for applications, which is everything's now gone electronic with AppliTrack. That would have been quite burdensome to have a current employee have to resubmit everything and redo all of that with an electronic media. So that was obviously not asked of any of our current staff. Once that process was finalized, after that, cabinet decided collectively that after June 15th, internal movements were concluded as per the wish list, and any remaining vacancies will be filled with the hiring process. Moving forward, of course, the cabinet's always open to suggestions about ways to streamline and expedite assignment and placement processes, but we feel that this process was able to effectively hit that target date, which, according to the contract, is that last day of school for issuing those assignment letters. And that's important. To continue beyond that, to create movement internally, would just create a revolving door of vacancies and really slow down the hiring process. So now principals get to work with HR and all of the applicants for these positions and begin hiring in earnest. Lastly, you'll have a packet here which will include a policy, an amended administrative regulation, and a former administrative regulation. In keeping with current board policy, I'm notifying the board that I've updated the outdated language of former administrative regulation 5512 letter R. The former language is in your packet. And the new edited language that's in keeping with current processes for teacher assignment and placement that coincide and align with the revisions to the school code that occurred with edits and updates to section 1248 and 1249 have been written, and those took place, those changes to the law in 2012. That was a whole lot of stuff, so if there are any questions, that concludes my update, but I did give you a lot of information for reference, so we can come back to it later if you haven't had time to read all of that. And I think I'll kick it over to Marianne.
I just have one comment. Noted that policy 5512 was not changed,
correct.
Just the regulations, the process, and procedure, but the actual policy was
correct.
Not changed.
And it's important to note, this edit might be in place for a month or two, maybe 2.5 months, but we are in the middle of our entire policy review and revision process. And so when that's done and the old policies are in place and adopted, we will then have to go through the step of marrying any internal policy language that we wish to continue and carry forward entire Neola policy, as well as all of the ad regs. But just like you get template policy, you also get template regs, which are customizable to the needs and the peculiarities of the district. So that process